Dirk,
Okay, so I will just share my screen with everybody. Please let me know if my slides are visible to each and everyone.
Yeah,
yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay, so my first request is if everybody can mute yourself, it will be wonderful. Thank you in advance. Good evening, good afternoon, and good morning to one and all present here. I, Dr. Tirtha Singh, first of all, I am representing definitely BioCruise organization. And today we are being collected to discuss about the IJCB. This is International Journal for Computational Biology that we started in 2012 under the aegis of BioCruise.org. So if you look at the website, everything is available on the website also. But when we started this, I remember Ritesh did a lots of hard work. He was behind this like a backbone for this IJCB. I just supported him throughout this journey in last 8 years. Prashant was also there always for boosting up, like do something good, get some good papers, publish some good work. And because we need to get recognized for the BioCruise organization. So core committee members of BioCruise were definitely instrumental in getting the ISSN number first, which is the prior most requirement for starting anything like this. And 2013, IJCB got launched on the OJS framework, and in 2016, it started operating as an independent publication unit. Progressively, we are becoming like truly international. If you look at our reviewing committee, editorial board members, contributing authors, they spread across the globe. Currently, it is functioning as a publication hub for research, primarily in the major domains of computational biology, bioinformatics, genomics, proteomics, and other allied disciplines. With more than 25 editorial members from all over the world, we are trying to strive for the excellence, and we are also following the open access policy in general. Like we are having the open access, but without any charges. So this is a special model because we were trying to support and promote science, and where money is not involved at that time, because that was the thinking, let's popularize this thing first, IJCB, BioCruise indirectly, and then we can later on change our model also. That was the plan. Following type of original contributions that are being peer-reviewed for publication, we are having acceptance for these, like commentary or editorial letter. Then we have the research articles, review articles, short communications, and technological reports on database and web servers. For editorial letters, I'm sure Professor German has done wonderful job in last many years. He provided a wonderful support for all these things. This is the very first look of the International Journal for Computational Biology website. You can see Ritesh had designed this actually. So this IJCB, you can see having a little bit of similarity with our Sanskrit language. We got ISSN numbers, and here are all the options. But this is going to tell you everything in detail. So my plan was to just give you a brief about the IJCB. Then we have the open access, like no article processing fee, no publication fee, and no open access fee. And recently, we have planned a special issue on COVID also. So I put that at the end. And in the meantime, we have also introduced and identified actually the DOI numbers. That work actually I did with one agency in Bangalore, because digital object identifier is a thing that is required when you are going for the open access platforms, and some other platforms, they actually require that. If you are not having DOI for your articles, then they will not include your journal in their indexing services. So that was another thing that we did, because we are paying for that. And that money we are paying from the account of BioCruise mainly. We did it this exercise. So what I did, whatever earlier publications were there for many issues, so I collected all that data with the help of Ritesh, and then I sent that data in the XML format to that agency. So they provided us the DOI number for all the articles that we included for this particular journal. And all the papers that are being accepted till date, they are all having their standard DOI numbers, so that can be easily accessed from anywhere. If you look at the editorial board and the managing editor board, we have Keshav and Krishna Mohan from as senior editor, then we have editorial board that we arrange alphabetically. So you can see Italy, Morocco, France, Denmark, USA, Japan, and other countries are involved. And so many of these people have reviewed our articles also, these editors also. We have sent them several articles and they have reviewed. And all the records are available with British and the general website. Then you can see the managing editors. We have now 6 managing editors. Abhishek and Aparna recently joined the team actually. So Abhishek is here from Institute of Bioinformatics, Bangalore. And Pritesh is here. I am also doing the work. So majorly Pritesh and me were doing this job for IJCB. But now Abhishek, Aparna has also joined. So now we have a very dynamic team. We can take help from Devendra also. So I hope we are going to do some wonderful jobs in the coming years for the promotion of this journal and indirectly the BioClues. I collected some pictures also from our own IJCB site. So you can see we started with 2012, volume 1, number 1. Then volume 2, number 1. Like in first 2 years, we published 1 issue in each year. But in 2014, we were able to publish 2 issues. So we thought like we were progressing. But, you know, everybody was busy with their own assignments also. Still, we were trying. 15 again, we have 2 issues. Then we have 16, then 17, 18, and 19, 19, 1 issue each year we have. And this year's articles are still pending. And with the help of new team, older team is always there to support. And we are going to have some interesting articles on COVID-19. So that is the special issue we have specifically designed and in the current pandemic situation. And we already started getting the manuscript for the same. So I'm sure this COVID issue will be a wonderful one. And besides that, we are having the regular issue also in parallel. So some articles are coming that we are going to include in the regular issue. So soon we are going to, by the end of this year, I'm sure two issues will be released, one regular and one specialized COVID issue. And in the meantime, I request all the core committee member, editorial board member, and their associates also, and the person who are listening now this, who are maybe not directly part of this team, but they are definitely indirect part of the team because IJCB belong to BioClues and BioClues belong to all of us. So my humble request is that let's contribute in the promotion of this journal. We can add more articles to it. And definitely we are coming up with some cumulative effect that will be reflected to the scientific community very soon. So with this, I am ending my presentation. Thank you very much, each and everyone.
Thank you, Raj.
Thank you, Dr. Tetra Singh. It was a very nice presentation. So, Dr. Pritesh, you can now start with the website so that we all can have an idea how to work with the website and for the submission and about the details of the website, please.
Yeah, thank you. So my screen is shared now. Can you? Yes.
Okay.
So well, since Raj has already given a good preamble about the journal, so I'll just directly start from the website and the nitty-gritty of the website and how it has been developed. So as you can see right now, we are in IJCB.in, that is the website of this this particular journal. And then we have like, you know, we started with this particular motto where this yellow part is there. So, you know, it's always a chicken and egg problem that when you start a new journal, you expect that some good publication and good manuscript will come to this. And then it needs a lot of effort. Like, you know, when you are saying that it has to go to the PubMed, it has to, the entire article, which is in either in Word format or LaTeX format, it has to be converted to XML. Because you know that all the indexing agencies, they actually do the citation analysis and they try to take this block of the data from a XML file. So now a few of the indexing are also taking JSON, but most of them are actually taking XML. So converting your file into the XML, and then, you know, you have to also check, although to convert this XML part, you have some automated software, but it do some errors. So somebody has to check it manually that you know the author name is there and there is another tab for the affiliation. So sometimes we do what happened that like you know the name will come to the affiliation will come to the name of the author. So somebody has to do the manual checking before uploading to the PubMed. Because once you do such type of mistake, then PubMed can block you for 2 years. And they don't listen to other argument. Okay. Now, when you started it, we thought that let's take some money, a very minimal thing so that our entire trace of, you can say, online issue of this journal will run smoothly. But then, you know, there was a big issues of this. So it's actually this concept is there everywhere. When somebody starts venturing into the market, it may be anything. It may be a journal, it may be a club, it can be a new business also. The opponent will always try to suppress. So there is always a concept of, you know, predatory journal. So, you know, we thought that once you start taking some article processing fees or publication fees, now there may be a chance that we are not going to get very good paper, and then people will start saying that these people are publishing the paper because just they are taking the money. So that was the initial idea, that let's make this entire issue without any article processing fees or publication fees. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible. Audible.
So we started with this option that let it be open access, it should be free to all, so that there will be more citation. And then in the same time, we shouldn't ask any publication or article processing fees, with a hope that nobody can blame us as a, you know, predatory journal, or they are just publishing something just because of money. Okay. So why I am telling all this thing, because I want to start with this particular concept. That's how we have started. And so in summarize, I can say that, you know, whatever issue we are right now having, like if you just go to the last tab, archive, you'll get this archive can give you the what are the different issues which we have received till now. So 12 and 13 we have two issues, and then 14 we have two separate issues, like volume 3 number 1 and 2. So all those are, like, just for example, if I'll just take this 2014, now all those publications here or manuscripts here, they are published without any additional fees. So, you know, starting from the copywriting, the proofreading, the editing, sending into the reviewer, sending them the reminder, again, assimilating everything, converting back to the particular layout, because if I'll just give you one idea about the layout, this is how the layout of the journal looks like, okay? So converting your doc file into this particular layout, and then checking all this thing, receiving date, revised date, accepted date, and then creating this unique code by scanning, which you can actually get the idea about the journal, and then aligning everything and taking this format out and publishing it. It actually like takes a lot of time. I mean, I will not say that you will have so much of a monetary factor involved here, but yes, it needs some time. And then similarly, you have to also do the tagging, you know, you have to check, like, these are all about the authors. So how you can print it out, like what are the indexing component of this thing, then how you can take this, downloading this thing. So converting this thing and then uploading into the particular website, which has a fairly restricted bandwidth, because we started with a very less amount. I think if you can remember, Raj, we started with only 10,000 rupees. And getting a hosting every year and then paying it. And then at one point of time, I have to again pay another 10,000 rupees just to increase the bandwidth. Because every manuscript here has 4 or 5 versions. One is the original version submitted, one is revised, one is finally copy proofed, then one is in final doc file and then converted to the PDF file. So these 4 and 5 files, they take a lot of space in your server. Yes. And if somebody is downloading it, it actually tries to cross-link everything. And due to that, a phenomenal amount of bandwidth actually is getting consumed. So you have to pay more for this bandwidth. Okay. Now, similarly, meantime, when we started with this open access model, so Professor Jayaraman was instrumental that time. He's actually the factor behind the first issues. And the first issue has received some very good paper across the globe, and actually you can see the editorial forward has been written by Professor Jayaraman only, and he actually, you know, did it in this way that although it was a first issue and then we have started the very humble way, but still then people from international academia has sent their paper and manuscript to this, and then we actually took a handful of them and few of them we have also rejected because of the quality and this thing, and then we started this entire journey. Okay, meantime people from different branch and different university and domain, they have associated themselves through the editorial team. And if you just go through the journal about section, here you will get an idea that what is the focus and scope. So what are the different type of submission, like just now Peter has told this thing, like we actually take commentary, short communication, research article, database and web server issue. And then it also tells a very effective way of doing the online submissions. So I like to tell something about online submission. Like unlike the other journal which actually do a same service without taking any extra revenue or generation or money part, so they actually do this email submission. Now we took a lot of pain just to develop this website. It's pretty automated, so I'll just log in and then I'll show you. So here, as a editor or any editor, any reviewer, if you just give the password, you will get this particular panel. This is not open for the author, but yes, it's there for editor. So here you can actually see that. So right now we have two issues which are yet to assign. We have four in editing. In fact, there was some issue with this, so we have revised it, but then it is yet to be deleted. And then you can actually do all type of all type of administration, like sending email, then sending the reminder to the reviewer, and everything is pretty automated. Like once you log into the system, it's equally good like any other manuscript central system which is being dealt by WILI or IEEE. Okay, then let me just log out. So we have around 200 users which is right now enrolled with this journal. There are three different type of enrollment. One is as a editor, second one is as a author or reviewer, and third one is as a plain reader. You know, you can simply log in into the thing and you can read different part of this journal. Now we have online submission system where template of the submission is given in PDF format as well as MS Doc format. Here the details about how to fix the format of the journal or manuscript is being discussed here. And then also we have like last time Jayaraman sir was asking that you should highlight it, so it is there. If you cannot create a online login for your submission, then you can certainly send this a email to igcp.in@gmail.com with a forwarding letter, and we are going to accept it because that particular email ID is accessible to the editor in chief or the managing editor with the issue editor. So right now I will say that I'll be sharing with Aparna or Abhishek, whoever is comfortable and has some time to check the email with a regular interval. So I'll be sending your email ID and then password. So it will be with you for a few months till this particular issue is there, like the COVID issue is there. And then, okay, so right now there is some issue with this online registration process. So if I just go through the registration process, so here you can see that this quote line, it is asking for some validation. Okay, and in the validation there should be a captcha here, Google captcha here, but it's not coming because the reason is the time when we developed this journal, it was using a PHP 6 format, and now it's actually the format is obsolete and the Google captcha is not following this thing. So I have started developing the new journal which is based on the new open access system. which need another few days because there was some issue with the login to the ISCB main website, which Pras knows this thing. And we are trying to sort it out. Meantime, I have already developed a local version in my server, taking as local host as my server, so I have developed one journal. Meantime, also I will be also thankful to Dr. Devendra, who has created a good look and feel HTML design. So I am trying to combine this HTML part with this my CSS part, so that the look and feel of the journal will be totally different. But there is actually a critical issue because this journal uses OJS, which is more of CSS and then PHP based. And since the website which Devendra and team has developed is HTML based, so there may be some issue in the integration, but I'm trying. We will resolve and we'll go to a point where everything will look fine. Meantime, the journal has also been indexed by several indexing agencies, and then so this open J gate, which is there in the second line, and the first J gate, they actually are the first. I'll say they are the first step to get it accessed by the indexing agency like Web of Science. So when you apply for Web of Science, they actually do the verification. At least in India, they do it through J gate. So J gate is already there, and we are already being indexed by J gate. So I think right now the time has come. We can go to the Web of Science, and Web of Science people can directly take our indexing and the citation data from J gate. So I don't have access, because it's a paid service on J gate, but then I have access to the IGCV, which a plain Google Scholar can just check you. And if you just say IGCV.in, you'll see that all these are being citation. Now they all are our paper. So two citation here, one citation here, citation, five citations here. So we'll just go through, and there are several such pages. So we have, like here there are four citations. Here this paper is being cited by one. So this is by three different citations are there. So what I'm saying, although it's a free journal, and then our indexing is not that perfect, well, we could have already gone for Scopus and Web of Science by now. Well, Scopus and Web of Science need some monetary involvement. Yes, like DOI just now, Tirath said, we need from just contribution from Raj and then. But when you are actually going through DOI and then you are applying for Scopus, you need some money. I mean, they actually ask around 18,000 per year to get into Scopus. They also say that we have to convert the entire thing into the XML sheet. So XML sheet needs some extra time and effort. So we need some money for that. Okay. So I think it has been also pointed out by Pras in last meeting that henceforth we'll at least make this provision that whoever is submitting the paper, he should also take one-time life membership. That is only 2,000 rupees, so it's not a big amount. So once you'll be life member of Bio Group, so the submission part can be webbed off. I don't know entirely. We are here to discuss those things, but then we can have some provision like that. Then it has also been achieved through multiple archiving agency, and then so it has also a very good searching engine. It actually took a lot of time, so you can search by author, title, abstract, keywords, and then publication type, and then publication time also you can this thing. Although we have the total number of papers right now are 50 odd papers, but then at one point of time, this search engine will be crucial to go through. So that's it for now. I mean, I think I have covered all the part, but then there are some pertinent issues and some questions which has been raised by Aparna and team. So now if all of you agree, we can I can close this thing and then we can go to those questions. So if you should actually decide and change the fate of the journal. And meantime, just now as discussed by Tirath Raj, a new issue for COVID-19 is already being released this year. And the editor-in-chief for this issue is Professor Veladi and Professor Sastri. And then you have managing editor Abhishek and Aparna ji. So thank you. I think Aparna, you can take ahead the floor, juice.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Preeti, for an excellent presentation. It's very clear, I think, for all of us, how it works and how the process is. So actually, we have some questions that I'm going to ask to all the members. And we hope that with this, all the people who are present over here will have a good couple of idea about the journal. So I will first start with the question, what is IJCB for you, International Journal of Computational Biology? And maybe we can start with Dr. Jayaraman Valladi. So we will go like Dr. Jayaraman Valladi to Dr. Devendra Biswal and Thitharaj Singh and Pritish, and then Dr. Abhishek will end. So if we can follow the same, and for all the questions, will be good.
Are we going to ask questions, or we are going to ask allow others to ask questions?
Actually, we have said these questions earlier, so let's go with all the questions, and if later the participants have some questions, so we will take those questions to us.
Right. So you're going to ask us to talk a little bit briefly, right?
Yes, about IJCB. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks a lot for giving me time, and thanks a lot for the excellent presentation, Dr. Thirithraj and Pritish. And in a small way, I was involved in the beginning of the journal. Now that time has to see, starting a journal is not as tough as sustaining a journal. And for sustaining a journal, we need a team of very active editors and co-editors with good administrative support. Maybe we need to pay some of the administrative support. So we need to find some finance for that. There must be a budget. And we must think of getting money through some means. Apart from that, we need to see, for sustaining the IJCB from now onwards, I suggest we keep two regular issues per year with five papers each in each issue. And in between, if we can also get involved with some conferences, some of it may be our own conferences, we can publish it in IJCB, the conference proceedings of good papers. We also have to popularize our journal by giving it to some table of content alerts. Maybe Springer, I think, is doing it for free. So we have to find out whichever agency or publisher is putting our table of alerts in their journals or in their websites. We must be able to do that. We also must popularize it individually in LinkedIn and Facebook of our private as well as group LinkedIns. So we must attract the bottom line is we need to attract people regularly to sustain the journal. So for that, as I said, the new committee, the new president, Dr. Sastri, has kindly agreed to have a relook at everything, the working of the BioClues as well as the journal. And we have to definitely the contingent journal's aim is to sustain a good journal and then keep running a journal must be one of our prime mottos, and then we should all try to get ourselves involved in spending more time. And somehow I think we need to sustain the journal by keeping an active role and combining it all our strengths, and then we must somehow provide support to BioClues and then sustain the journal. So with this, I'll come back again if anything is if others. I will give chance for others to speak. Yeah, thanks a lot. Yeah.
So thank you, Dr. Jayaraman Valladi, for your inputs. So if we can start with Dr. Biswal, if you can give some of your inputs on this.
Thanks, Aparna, for giving me a chance to speak something on this journal, International Journal for Computational Biology. I'm audible, right?
Yes, you are audible. Yes.
So, frankly speaking, I didn't know much about this journal till I joined BioClues. So, I was very much excited for me, not only for me, for every researcher, as we all know, publishing a work is really, really very important. Like, we have to work hard, finish, and publish. These are the three important words that always goes in my mind. And when you want to publish whatever work you have done, it has to be published in an authenticated way where peers and they come together and review our work, and this peer review process should be very, very fair. So from that perspective, I think IGCB should stand high in the coming years. And as Pratish was giving an excellent presentation about the very inception of this novel idea to have a journal, and now that we are in a mood to project this journal as a community journal for BioClose, it will be really, really very interesting. And we'll be having more ideas. And as Jayaraman sir has rightly said, we need some appropriate finance for the administrative staff, be it one or two. Or we'll start with a very few number of administrative staff, because we as scientists, we cannot afford much time for the journal to look into it from the administrative perspective. So basically, what I understand is that in this world of 21st century, where social networks, file sharing services for the scientists, and preprint servers, or let us say the post-publication evaluation, data sharing, text and data mining, all these things have come up. So I think this particular journal lives up to its standard in the coming years, and I want to see IGCB emerge as one of the most successful bioinformatics journals at international level, and the sooner the best. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Vishwari. You are correct. We all actually hope that IGCB emerge as an international journal in the field of bioinformatics. You are perfectly right on this. And so we will next go to Dr. Titraj Singh, then Dr. Pritish, and in the last to Dr. Abhishek to sum up with this question.
Okay, thank you, Parna. As I already gave lots of information about IGCB, I just wanted to add that BioClose and IGCB, they are like our own child. We are trying to nurture them from last one, like from almost 15 years, and this one from almost more than 8 years. So definitely monetary conditions should be checked, because money is always required to manage this kind of complicated processes. Until now we were fine. As I was not present in the last meeting, unfortunately, and I think quorum was already passed. Like, if somebody's paper is being accepted in IGCB, he or she will take the life membership for BioClose. So if you all agree, then we can pass this quorum and we can apply this. The condition is anybody can submit the paper to IGCB. It will be reviewed. But if the paper is accepted after review, then only he or she has to submit the life membership fee. If paper is rejected, then there is no open access of processing fee for that particular process. So this is my suggestion. If everybody will agree, we can pass this one. And I'm sure with the help of each and everyone, we are going to make it a successful journal. We are going to take it to newer heights. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Titraj Singh. Yes, we actually have talked about this, and in the next meeting also, we will talk about this for the growth of the journal and also the growth of our organization. So, Dr. Pritish, please, your view on this.
Thank you. So, shall I take, what about those five questions which you have asked? So, shall I throw my views on those five questions, or you want me to tell something different?
No, I think your view on, or your overview on IGCB, and if you don't have something more.
Yeah, so IGCB, there are two issues which need to be solved as soon as possible, as per my best understanding. One is the database and the new website issue, which I am pretty confident will be up very soon. Once this log in through SiteGround, there is some issue which Pras and me are trying to resolve. Once that is okay, we can host it. It will be a brand new system with almost all, essentially all these good things which is there in the top-notch journal like in IEEE and WILI. We'll develop a system for that, and then I'm ready to complain about that. Okay. Now, point number two is that we need to also have a sustainable model. That means we need some revenue. So, as far as I can imagine, and I can summarize the thing which has been told by multiple persons like Raj, Devendra Ji, and then Raj Ji, and then Professor Dhaladi. So, you know, we can start with a small office. I don't know, like if the Professor Shastri sir can help us in this way or not, because last time he was saying that he has some plan or some idea to make this thing more smoother managed. And then second point is that can you also ask some money, like some budget from this the author, like once his or her paper is published. I think we should. Because right now, I think we are right now out of those tag of calling ourselves as predatory journal, because we are doing it last 9 years without even a single penny. I mean, we can proudly say the entire the issue, the entire launch of the journal for last 9 years has not generated a single penny out of this. So this is a perfectly free thing, and then we are not taking any money, any sort of publication fees or journal issue clearance fees, nothing. Okay, but now it's difficult to sustain. So let's take some money, but not in the form of manuscript. But let's do like this: like whoever the paper is getting accepted, you know, we can ask him or her to get enrolled into the BioClues as a lifetime membership with some provision. I don't know if people can suggest me. With some provision that for remaining every paper which he or she will be submitting in future, will have you know, a implication like only 200 or 500 rupees. I don't know. I mean, instead of giving 2000, he or she can give only 200 rupees or 300 rupees for remaining every publication which he or she may like to have through IJCP. That is one way of doing this thing. And the second point is that what Jayaraman sir has just now suggested, that I think it's a high time we should go for some commercially feasible option, like going for some publication houses like Springer or Zyber or Bentham in that way. So I'm sure. But then yes, I had some contact with Springer people. If you all agree, we can start talking with them. But I am not sure whether this entire service will be free or not. Because it may be free, but when you have, you know, hundreds of papers are coming to your journal, and then you have few hundred papers already into your this thing, then publisher may be free. So let's start talking. I don't know. I mean, before starting the talk, I should be pre-assumptive, but then yes, let's assume that we will get some good result out of our talk. And then if everything goes fine, this COVID issue, I'm not sure, but at least I can make some good prediction that, well, if this new issue hooks right now, Aparna, Abhishek, and Baladi sir and Satvi sir as taking care of, I think the new issue will come on a new website with a new feel and look, if not through Springer and Elsevier, but yes, it will be on a new website. Thank you. That's it for me.
Thank you, Dr. Pritish. You have also put a light on our special COVID issue. And I will request Dr. Abhishek, because he is handling the COVID issue. So please put your light on the COVID issue too. And what are the target research that we may publish in IJCB along with IJCB? Because Dr. Abhishek will be the perfect one to put the light on the current special issue. Dr. Abhishek, please.
Thank you. I also, when I came here and before that, I came to know about the journal, and the journal was doing so. I was following the journal for some time, and since the journal has passed, survived more than 5 years without any allegations and also without cost, and it's like already growing like we are growing. So we need to sustain it, and we need to have made the necessary changes. So my recommendation will be that first and last author, so suppose I am a corresponding author, my student should be becoming life member to avail the, so that PI will be offering us his student a kind of a gift for being first author of the hardworking person as a life membership plus the some money that would float into journals, yeah, a life membership. And so the both should be the that can be one criteria. Another criteria could be that we charge them, and we have to make it this change very quickly because we are now receiving COVID issue and other issues, some papers as well. So that's why I put it up front. Yeah, so this is a major reason why I put it. And then if somebody is not willing, we have a fee to processing fee, yeah, something like this, something like 5,000 rupees or something, and which is required to sustain the journal. So that's processing means it's not coming to my pocket, right? So it's important. Although we all have this emotional, as an Indian, we all have this emotional baggage that everything should be free because how people will reach to the people. But those who are doing science, I assume that they are able to afford it. Yeah? And so therefore, we have to find, and we can, if they are paying, we can keep some of the papers free also. It's on the special request of the author when they cannot sustain it. So, and also we're giving life members also rebate, right? So this, apart from that, in COVID-19, we have started an issue, and papers, one paper is reviews have already come, and we are trying to have at least 5 to 6 papers. So one of the paper from my group will go, and I'll request the those who are working here as well as those who will see the video to submit their papers in the COVID-19 issue of our journal. And we will be extremely fast. At the moment, we are working with the email, and so it goes into revision within 24 hours of the once received. And so that week we can give you, and the reviewers will ask in 15 days, but due to COVID-19, we are also aware that they will be disturbed. And so if they do it, so we are sending at least 4 to 5 reviewers, whichever 3 first comes, we will serve back to the author. So we are basically, COVID-19 in next 3-4 months, we will come up with 4 to 6 papers. And if the others are listening, because at least 3 to 4 different groups have contacted me, and they need some time. And some of my students are also listening. So one of our or two of our papers will be submitted here. So be mentally ready and prepared for it. And so with this, I'm requesting all of you, those who are working on COVID-19, to write it, plus consider and tell others, yeah? And until unless we'll stand up on our foot, and start looking towards other country journals, rather than we have to pull this out. So that will be support, and it is required. Yeah? So I also understand, as a new PI, I also understand if I'm what happens to my career. But then if I can do some papers, why not? I should do it. And consider is one valuable small paper also, which has a significance. You please publish it, and also I request you, if you have proceedings for journals like Tikam, Dr. Tikam, who has joined, has a COVID-19 proceeding, which he can publish. He is now our new editorial board member. Please submit it, and I am also proudly announcing you that we are organizing International Conference of Data Sciences, and we were discussing internally to bring all the abstract from the speaker to the proceeding in a form of proceeding, and that will come to IC, our journal, International Journal of Computational Biology. I just now had a discussion with Pras, and also that we, since I am editor, so as a, we have, we can easily convert it to the, this direction, and also Pankaj, who is Yadav, who is a co-convener of or dual convener of the conference, is also editor, so we can easily pull it towards this direction. And this is called, this conference is 100% free, so we are not charging anybody anything, and we have about 2,000 registrations already. And so, and those who are registering, we will be flashing the, flashing every before and after the talk, flashing the advertisement. And at this moment, I have an announcement. If you are, one of you will agree, I'm trying to reach. If you, one of you will agree, Aparna or anyone, please give a presentation for 10 minutes in the, about this conference in, in the conference about the journal, so that more and more people are aware, more and more, you know, the videos are placed in internet. Videos play important role, as you know. I only watch on YouTube, whatever material is available on YouTube. So it's a revolutionary change. So we have to accept it, and we have to also make, so this, this audio video recording will be also going, I think. And so that's my overall view. Then we are, let us pull this COVID-19 along with everyone, and if we can, then this will give me also confidence, others also, that that we can pull it. And so we have some new editors, and three new editors I requested, and they agreed. Tikam is sitting here, he's a good friend of mine, and he's a peer, he invited me, and we met, and that scientific friend. So and then Pankaj from IIT Jodhpur, and Professor Yusuf Malik from Israel has agreed to join the meeting, editorial board. And so they will be coming on the web page, and they already asked me why their names are not there. So if you are, please, we can update their names. I have told that since we have a new website coming up, we will be coming. But their names, since they have agreed, and they have, they are also part of it. So if it is possible, just add their names, and I will. And they are also pulling their papers. And I request all of you, those who are, who like the idea of having a societal journal where the journal, you are part of society as well as a part of the growth of the journal, to pull one paper. And sometimes it may look like sacrifice, but you never know that tomorrow the impact factor is 5, 10 or something like that. So then... you say, oh, that time Abhishek was telling me this. So basically, pull one something which can be done. And I'm trying my best to bring as many as paper in next 12 month. And the COVID-19 for sure. And some of my students are aware that their paper is coming. So, and also some papers and some laboratory, also I request, apart from COVID-19, I'm taking a little bit more time, but that if you have a laboratory protocol, protocols of some computational analysis, very basic computational analysis also, like how to do phylogenetic analysis, these type of papers, standard protocols, it can also be published, and a lot of journals publish that. So it's a very basic understanding, so that next generation can use. So some of the tools are very 25 years back, very common, but they are very useful, but their protocols are outdated today. So can we pull those methods which you are regularly using with help of a person who is doing repeating the analysis, will be also a good idea to have a we can say protocol, as Prash has already told, a protocol issue. in issue, it can be a protocol and sometimes software, something like that. We can be also very good idea to have. And nobody knows that in the next 10 years, so when you are talking, we will be in a different front. Eh? So that's my expectation, and that's what. I'm really thankful to those who have started, and their work is appreciable. And in the era where this last 10 years, everything which came actually went to predatory. Yeah? Even very good journals also went to predatory when they become very popular. People started publishing. People started doubting them. Many of them are listed, and they get delisted out of it. So in those era, you kept running for 10 years and with caution, yeah, with your work and with cautious approach. Now we have to generate the money, and we have to think more than one ways to sustain it if we can. And but then obviously the fee issue is definitely there. And I am saying that my idea, if you openly, and normally I talk openly, so first and last author should be take a live membership. That live membership of those will be given to the journals development, and some portion might be taken, and they will get a benefit out of it. So there'll be if a PhD student get a societal benefit, email ID benefit, and a lot of other benefits which society is providing. This is bonus for them. And then the paper also. And if not, somebody want to publish, let's have some nominal fee. And because many journals keep asking fee. And so our first priority will be membership. If the person takes membership, it will be lower rate, and then slightly higher for those who will not take membership. Because it's an international journal, and sometimes persons sitting in another globe may not want to take a membership or maybe because of that other region, but want to publish, they pay and publish for the processing fee. And also we'll keep optional that if you are paying, somebody else will, when they are coming with the genuine reason that they are not able to pay. So a lot of colleges and in last 10 years, a lot of colleges also publish paper, and they have really no budget. Yeah, so we have to support them because they are doing science. At least in computational biology, I've seen that they are trying their best, yeah, what they can do. So basically, we have to support them. And so then if they are coming with, they have no budget, and student papers, where the students have written the papers, those papers where they cannot pay, we'll still give them the rebate, right? So with this, we have to have a very clear agenda on it, that these are the points, and you can also tell me that if I'm wrong, but I am just putting it so that everybody knows that how the way I am thinking, and an agreeable solution will come up with agenda, this clear agenda that, but we have to do it very fast because the issues are coming, and a new way along with the new website, or even pre to new website, we have to take make a note of that actually. So those one suppose the paper is under review now, we can't tell them, but if the new paper is coming, definitely. Yeah, so I talk a lot. Thank you, Aparna, please.
Hello. So thank you, Dr. Abhishek. Dr. Abhishek has rightly put the important lights on actually all the points that we had about IJCB, about the COVID special issue, and the target research that can be published in IJCB. So actually because we are running out of time and we need to take questions from others, so actually I will try to ask the question about the future vision of IJCB to all five people who we have in board here, to give their inputs on what we have the future vision about IJCB. Dr. Jayaraman Valadi, Dr. Bishwal,
yeah,
Dr.
Yeah, Titya. Yeah. In my opinion, the present and future vision is to become a journal of excellence with continued without a break publishing at least twice or thrice in a year, with good international authors coming and contributing, and sustaining it with no or very little open access fee. Yeah.
Exactly. So if anyone of you please want to speak on this, our future vision.
Okay, so my I'm again back.
Yes, please. So,
my vision for my next 5-year goal will be to index this properly. Solve the.
That's a one year goal, Abhishek. Not 5 years.
Okay, but yeah. I'm adding all five other goals, and then to have impact factor, and then regular publication. Every 5 year means every 1 year with some other goals. So basically, and regular publication, and then after 5 years, people should say, okay, mere paas ek paper hai, main kyun nahi isko, why don't I put it in this journal? Yeah, and then go to some other computational journal. And that's possible. And then we have to chalk out how we can do it. So basically, in the last 15-20 years, a lot of new journals have come. And so we have to take advice from some of the people who have managed those journals, so maybe if required. And strategies, yeah. So each person has to take some efforts, telling others, and this one will go to the video. Other outreaching is very important. Any request all editors to, at the end of your presentation, please recommend others wherever you are giving a presentation, and whichever conference proceedings we can get. We can get recognition only by step by step. So so once we reach there, we should get it. So if you are getting into BioClues societal conferences, we should get it. If I am contributing somewhere where I am having in a controlling role, I should put this word to the conference that please add me. Add me to the please come to us for the publishing and their proceedings. And proceedings also start is a good starting point, because slowly people will reach to us, so the overall in the 5 year of substantial growth from here on. And we double the rate. The initial child has a lot of problems, and they are already 10 year old. And now, thank you all of you who has grown it up. And now it's our role. And I hope that we can bring some new members as editorial board members, and also effectively all of us will take care of this for the near future. So that's it from my side.
Aparna, thank you. Yes. Can I suggest something?
Please.
First of all, thanks to all. Dr. Abhishek has already, I think, already mentioned all the points and the visions and everything. For me, what I think is that for the first year, we just have to focus on get our journal indexed in UGC CLEAR, and then in the Web of Science, and on which we all already are working on also. So that is the first priority, because for anyone, like, you know, even if you have any bioinformatics work or computational biology work, and when you go into the Google and you try to search that what are the good journals, then people, they see about this type of indexing. This is really very important. So I think that funds would not be a problem. Once we are in a UGC CLEAR list, so people would be happy, even if, like, you know, they can pay at least a small amount as an article processing for this. That would not be a problem. I think that Am I audible?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. So I think that with this, I hope that within a year or two, we may, I think right now.
Yeah, it's a good suggestion. In fact, we should go for the indexing first.
If we are indexed, so paying like a 10,000 rupees or 15,000 rupees would not be a problem as an article processing.
Is an example only. Independent and starts with indexing. So if indexing is there, everything else starts there. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry to interrupt you. Want to tell you that I have seen the care form also, and I am in consultation with the ICSE team of my university actually. I was discussing with them because that form has to be forwarded by ICSE team. Nowadays they have a new clause. So I already consulted this thing with them. The only concern was that because we are having this through Bayer organization, the head office is in Hyderabad, so there is little technical complicacy while applying this journal. So what we have to do, we have to make a team and we have to apply to multiple agencies for the same journal. Then there are chances of fit selection. And I already started working on it. Just an update for this.
Yeah. Another one suggestion is that like we have a COVID special issue right now because this is a COVID pandemic situation. So this is like a very attracting issue. So people are working on this, and so we can expect a publication on this one. So maybe have like some more of such kind of special issues, like not just one in a year, maybe like two or three, so that you know in those special issues we may ask for some article processing fees also, and of course we will have the more number of papers also. So in that case, like you know. Why to be only just like we are publishing only twice a year, so we can go up to the like you know quarterly journal. We can become a quarterly journal in that case. I have just these two suggestions.
Yeah, Tikan, thank you so much. In fact, we have started with the idea of starting a quarterly thing.
Yeah,
because of the submission, the idea was like you know try to restrict the quality. So I mean, we have to somehow tune down to one or two issue. Initially, the idea was to go for quarterly, but yes, rightly said, if the you know the overall increment among the all the members of this group is there, then certainly why not? We can actually go for 6 issue also. I mean, nobody stops.
Yeah, because now we have only published a few issues, like you know one issue in 2012 and 13. So if someone look at the journal, it seems to them that okay, yes, it's a very new journal, you know. So if we had like a more of the issue, something like that, you know, at least at the start, like it would be hard journey a little bit. Yes, of course, we all have to work together in a like a very industrious way. But of course, we will do. But these are my suggestions. But of course, we are working on this. These suggestions, so it's okay.
Yeah, actually, this video will go online, so we'll have a internal meeting or. And so basically there is a requirement for an open discussion on within editors, and you are Natikam and Pankaj is not here today, and also Yusuf Malik. I am convening my voice that all editors are independent to think what they can bring. Yeah. Suppose you can bring one special issue, you are most welcome. Yeah.
So okay.
Basically, the initial starters have bring it until now. They have baked the cake. Now we have to do the icing. Yeah.
Okay.
So all the suggestions will be positively considered. Yeah. So okay. I bring the I just told COVID issue. Everybody agreed. Yeah. And then I bring it tomorrow, marine genomics or secondary metabolites, which I'm working on, they will be again agreeing for it. So, and then we also have to, if we can bring 5 papers, let's have 5 papers all together, 5, you speak to the 5 prospective people that they will submit together, and then we can very quickly bring it within 3 months also, it is possible, right? And in COVID, everybody want to publish in a very large scale journal where Sayad koi bhi lega. That kind of approach people are following. So they are not looking towards us very rigorously. So if we think we can publish on cancer genetics, I'm ready to contribute. And just think that two of us from any subject, and I'm going to also discuss him with international speakers and national speakers, editors, that can we come up with a machine learning or deep learning papers. Yeah. And just discuss, like make a small group within our editorial board, and if you have a proposal, then we will definitely consider it. And internal issues will discuss separately. Maybe call a personal meeting. This will go into. Do not mind anybody. Keep it slightly shorter. Shorter, because otherwise it's very good to discuss openly. Yeah, so it's, I like this, and I like it to make it public also. So the difference of opinion is very important to make it public. But at the same time, as far as I understood the journal, I'm not part of the initial journal. So journal very happily accepted me, and many of us whom I know. And so now we come up with anything, they will accept it, and they are very, very generous in that aspect. And what topic I said, I actually mean it. Yeah. So I have said cancer genetics, secondary metabolite, marine genetics. I will be able to contribute also. And I request Tikam, please, this proceeding, please work on it a little bit, maybe 4 pages for your conference, and submit it here. And I will also submit it for my COVID-19 meeting, as well as this. I am organizing one more here, so that we will have a three. So if you work out, 3 proceedings are already there. So and proceedings are very easy, because now the abstract we have already requested the speaker. Then we'll wind up with the saying that this is the agenda, and then. And also this meeting which we are organizing,
I think we are like 1 hour and 15 minutes. So can we just take the other question, because there are many who have participated here and maybe definitely have some questions regarding the special issue and their questions related to the submission. So I think we discuss this later and can have the questions now.
Yeah, please.
Yes, I request anyone here, if you have some question, we are
having. Can I come in, Dr. Aparna? Yeah, just yes, a suggestion. Please. I'll just take 1 minute. Just a suggestion. You know, when you look at the university or any of the institution, every young researcher is looking at the promotion venues, and there the publication is very, very important. And I'm running a journal in NEO, so the first thing they look at it is this listed. And once you get listed, I think there are good articles which are going to come. That will publicize, and once you have the publicity, there is going to be increase in citation. With increase in citation comes the impact factor, and with the impact, you'll have flooding of articles. Then we can think of charging. This for me that looks sequential one. I may be wrong. And the other thing is, I was just going through the editorial board. I think we need to also update on that. If I'm not wrong, Professor Lalji Singh departed in 2017, the father of Indian DNA fingerprinting. I think those are things which we just need to be updating, so that people know that they are working continuously. Sometimes this also gives the first image of how the journal is. The journal out get up and layout is so beautiful. I'm just going through while you're talking. It's better than any of the journals I find majority in UGC care list. So with all this quality, I think there should not be a problem in putting it in care list. For me, if you take my suggestion, that's my priority. Thank you.
Thank you. I will request the others, if you have some questions, Professor Jayaraman, if you want to speak something about the journal, and everyone present over here, about your questions regarding the special issue or your submission related question. We all are here, so you can definitely ask some questions regarding it now. Please feel free to ask questions.
Yeah, if anyone has some questions, please come forward and ask. Yeah. Dr. Sugu, you have something to talk?
No, sir. I think as of now.
Okay. So, yeah.
If, thank you. Thank you.
Anybody else?
If no one has some question, I will ask either Prash or Professor Jayaraman Baladi to end up with your, because Prash have been with us for a long time. So I will ask Prash or Professor Jayaraman Baladi being the.
Prash is there. Prash has left. Is he there? Hello, Prash?
Yes, sir. I'm here, sir.
I think we have talked a lot. I think we should hear from you at least the final concluding remarks. Before you give the final concluding remarks, I would request every one of us here. The around 20 people are there. So let us try to put one of our recent best works with our students. Let it be a short work, but let us try to sacrifice it instead of sending it to an international journal. And then for the sake of the society and for the sake of ISCB, let us publish it in this journal. That is our, that's my top priority and request. Yeah. After that, Prash, please.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Apana, for the opportunity. I think first I would echo Dr. Joshi's point on the layout of the journal. It's been an excellent layout, and that's the brainchild of Pritesh. He has been an amazing web developer. That's how he has taken all those kind of strains over the years. I also liked it. My fate may know, but sometimes, although I had a kind of an impression that we should never publish in our own family journals, sometimes मुझे कभी-कभी लगता है वो layout देख के खुद एक journal एक paper कुछ कुछ लिख के डाल दो that is how the layout is. And I know Pritesh and Raj have really put a strenuous effort on this. Sincere kudos to them backed by Jayaraman sir. And now it has given enough strengths with the addition of Abhishek, Aparna, Dev and Tikam. And I'm sure we should reach a pinnacle of success in bringing more glories to the journal and also to BioClose. I would like to sincerely thank all the panelists today. So it's a kind of a vote of thanks kind of thing. But for the other 14 odd people who are here, especially the young students over here or who really wanted to publish certain things, there are two messages that I really wanted to give. One is, COVID is a kind of a blessing in disguise to many. I mean, it's not that, many of us think that, we are staying away from the lab, probably not really not going to lab, maybe, becoming, fat or motapa or whatever, some, vicious thoughts might really, crept in our minds. This is an opportunity for the young minds to write a wonderful review article. And for that, we at BioClose and IGCB would be more than willing to help you in this particular regard. There are many mentors, all of the editors over here, they have had, a cumulative experience of more than 200 years. That's a wonderful and amazing thing. I think, this is an opportunity, this is time where you join forces and write a good review article. And this is where, COVID is really kind of a blessing in disguise in one front. Second thing, IGCB has changed the way I should think. Ever since it was started, I always, as I told you, that, we should never publish in our own family-based journals. Over the years, I think during the last two or three meetings where I was also involved, Jayaraman sir, Abhishek, Tidraj and Pritesh, they made a very striking remark and a very good point. If we are not, trying to bring up, that glory and come up with a good article, बाकी लोग कैसे वो पर्टिकुलर सीरियसनेस इंस्टिगेट करेंगे दैट वाज अ वेल मेड पॉइंट एंड आई थिंक वी ऑल शुड कम अप विद अ गुड आर्टिकल लेट देयर बी अ फेयर पीयर रिव्यू व्हिच हैज ऑलरेडी बीन देयर व्हिच प्रदीश हैज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड ओवर द इयर्स लेट देयर बी अ फेयर पीयर रिव्यू ऐसा नहीं है कि हमारा जर्नल है हम कुछ भी क्रैप जो लिखेंगे वो पब्लिश करेंगे ऐसे थोड़ी है ऐसा नहीं है सो लेट देयर बी अ फेयर पीयर रिव्यू लेट देयर बी अ काइंड ऑफ एन ऑनर्स ऑन द यंगर जनरेशन टू टेक अ लीफ from people like us. So that was you know, my point. And with these final words, I would like to thank each one of you for giving me this opportunity. Thank you and namaskar.
Thank you, Prash, for your comment. So if we can hear to you, Professor Jayaraman Valladi, to end up with some talk, and we can have our panel discussion in today.
And a lot of things we have talked about, everything under the sun. About So I think with this we can finish. I think only thing is we all must strive together to bring it to an excellent journal, which survives for a very long time and becomes a very high impact factor, well respected journal. With these words, I think let me finish.
Thank you. So thank you, everyone. We have talked about everything related to IJCB, and please feel free to contact us in the IJCB mail. We have already sent the mail ID to all the groups. So I think everyone already knows about the mail ID. So feel free to contact for your publications, for any of your questions, and we will be very happy to answer your questions or any suggestions regarding to the journal or regarding submission. So thank you all. I think we can finish over here.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much, everybody, and thank you, Aparna, for being good hosting the meeting.
Aparna, are the five people going to talk about 10-15 minutes?
Okay. Yes. Please. We are staying here. Yes.
Yeah, Aparna, Stitraj, Pratish, Devendra, myself, and who else? Abhishek will stay back. Yeah.
Okay, sure.
Yeah.
Sir, excuse me, sir. Can we request Joshi sir also to stay back?
Yeah. Joshi sir, please stay back. Yeah.
And I think Tikam also, because he is also now in our team.
Okay. Right.
So we should thank IIM as well, you know, for the wonderful recording that he has been making. Thank you so much, IIM. Thank you, you know, for all the help.
Yeah, thanks a lot,
IIM.
Thank you, IIM.
I wanted to speak to Dr. Pras. So, Dr. Pras, will you be free after 9 or something? Once we come out of this
session. Sure, Joshi. Yeah, we could talk. Yeah. Please, yeah. Thank you. Bye-bye. Yeah.